It's finally here. The beta version of V-ray 5 is out with some significant new features. Hi, it's Hadi again from HM Studio, and in this video we're going through some of the most important features of V-ray 5 and I'm going to show you how to use them. So, without any further ado, let's start. The first thing that I'm really excited about in this update is V-ray Lightmixer. To be honest, Corona Lightmixer was a game changer in the archviz industry. A lot of archviz artists are still using Corona Renderer only because of its Lightmixer. But now, we have this in V-ray, which is amazing. With the V-ray Lightmixer, the intensity and color of the lights and light-emitting materials can be changed directly from the V-ray frame buffer during and after rendering. This will save you a lot of time because you can extract so many different lighting moods out of one render. To start using Lightmixer, you just need to simply add it to render elements. Just make sure to enable denoise right here. This option specifies whether to denoise this render element or not. Then, from here, you could choose how to group the lighting information. Individual lights will provide a separate channel for each individual light in the scene, which in my opinion is not very practical. Instance light, which is my second favorite after group light, specifies which lights are instanced, and if there are instance light in the scene, each group will have a separate channel. Group lights, which is the best option, will make a separate channel for each group of lights. For example, if you're using the same V-ray IES for the living room and the kitchen, you could make two groups of lights. Although they are instanced, but you will have two channels in the light mixer. I'm going to show you how that works in a minute. With layers option, V-ray will make a separate channel for each group of lights in different layers. But that seems like some extra work, right? And finally, manual light selects makes you able to add lights into different channels, simply by adding a V-ray light select element and adding your group of lights into that element. Alright, now let's see how this light mixer works. I've already illuminated this scene with an HDRI light and different types of V-ray light, and I'm going to use the group lights option, which is my favorite. As I said before, I have some instance lights as my halogens here, but I've separated them into two groups, living room and kitchen. Therefore, I will have two separated channels for them in the light mixer. Just don't forget to name your lights and groups, cause it'll be so much easier to edit them later in the frame buffer. I've already rendered some shots, which you can see here in the history panel, and we're going to modify some of them. As you can see, the frame buffer window has completely changed. But here on the layers panel is where the magic happens. Here we have the lens effects, denoiser, and source. I just need to select the source to be able to access the light mixer over here. Alright, here are all the groups with the names I've chosen for them. That is why you need to name your groups and individual lights so you can find them easier. This is pretty simple. We have two options for each channel, intensity and color. You can turn each of them on and off also. Okay, let's say I want to make a dusk mode out of this render. First of all, I'm going to turn off all the channels and then modify them one by one. For the environment, I need a dark bluish tint like this color over here. And also a little bit of more intensity, so I'm going to increase this number. For this pendant light, I need a warmer color and more exposure also. So let's choose this color and increase the intensity a little bit. Okay, I'm going to modify the other lights as well. Okay, it seems that I need a little bit of more contrast on this image. I could do that by adding a curves layer by clicking on this button over here and selecting curves. Now I can increase the contrast by making an S-shaped curve like this. The shape of this curve would be different for each scene, but this is pretty much everything we need to do to give some contrast to any image. So, Using LightMix here is the first way that you could modify your lights. Or you can do that by using composite by clicking over here. With the composite, you'll get different layers for different channels. As you can see, you can change the blending mode for each of these layers over here. And you can add any of these layers to whichever of these channels you want. Let's say I want to add some exposure to this cabinet light. I could easily add an exposure layer to this channel and tweak the values until I get the desired effect. The beauty of this composite is that you're not limited to just two options. So in this aspect, I think Vray went one step further than Corona Renderer. The next thing I want to show you is Vray Asset Browser. We finally have a built-in material library for Vray with 20 different categories in here to choose from. For any of these materials, you could add it to Material Editor and modify it if necessary. Otherwise, you could just apply the material to your objects and start the rendering. Okay guys, those were the most important updates for Vray 5. This beta version still has a lot of bugs and problems. But I'm sure the final release will really be worth a try. Thanks for joining me today, and if you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comment section. Also, if you found this video helpful, be sure to like and subscribe to the channel, and don't forget to hit the notification button. See you next time.